And now a major update in an I-team investigation that you first saw here a year ago. An attorney who filed a lawsuit on behalf of the residents of Fairway Oaks, that's a local neighborhood built on a landfill years ago, says both the city and government and HabiJax have now responded to his class action lawsuit.
This is the view of the Northwest Jacksonville subdivision from our Sky 4 drone. HabiJax built the community 16 years ago. Residents have been begging the city and HabiJax for help for the past decade after their homes began splitting in half and sinking. The attorney who filed the lawsuit spoke with Channel 4's Francesca Amaker.
Yeah, this attorney does not seem to be backing down. He says he will prevail. In fact, he's already in the written discovery process and says he's received nearly 60 affidavits from different residents, all claiming that they did not receive any type of note saying that their homes were built on contaminated land, and he's ready to get them justice.
The homeowners are excited. They're energized. They are some of the most, some of the strongest people I've ever met. They are individuals that have endured a really difficult time in their lives, and they need resolution.
He's only been by their side for a few months, but already attorney Jack Crumbine has been able to give residents of Fairway Oaks more hope than anyone who has stepped foot in their sinking and cracking homes. When my I-team investigation began in May 2016, we uncovered that 75 homes were built on a former city dump, and that caused homes to settle and split in half. When we reached out to HabiJax, we were told homes were breaking in half because of lack of maintenance and not from poor construction. The city also did little to resolve any issues. Now, after serving both the city and HabiJax with a class action lawsuit, Crumbin says both parties have responded.
The defendants have filed motions to dismiss, which were very interesting in themselves.
In their response, Crumbine says HabiJax and the city said the statute of limitations to file a lawsuit had expired, but he says several agreements, which would extend that time frame, were negotiated by his client's previous attorneys. The city and HabiJax failed to put that in their motions. Now, as the case nears its first hearing set for January, he says it's important for it to move quickly.
I guess my biggest concern is that the amount of time it's going to take before we have adjudication by a jury. Fortunately, we have a system that allows for a jury.
Crumbin says he is also grateful to the Jacksonville Legal Aid for assisting him and helping him in this, but he does say that he wishes that it didn't take him to get involved for these folks to receive justice. Also, we do know that the residents are asking for an undisclosed amount in damages. For now, reporting, Francesca Amaker, Channel 4, the local station.